post one, and then we'll have their open introductions, and this time we'll start with Marcelo Zapata.
Thank you to the Roosevelt Women Club for organizing this event, and for all of you for being here today with us to learn more directly from the candidates. As a citizen of this great nation, I'm grateful for many things that are unique to our country. I love that government flows from the bottom up, not from the top down. The Constitution says that ours is a government of the people, by the people, for the people. That is even more true for local government, because it has the biggest impact on our everyday life. Roosevelt is a great city, and my family and I have been blessed to live here. But I know our city can do even greater, and that is why I'm running for post one. We need fundamental change in this city council, because the people who represent us have lost touch of our concerns. I represent the departure from irresponsible high-density development over the objection of residents and without supporting infrastructure first, from bumper-to-bumper traffic 7 days a week on local and state roads, and from decisions made without solid data to support them. I also believe our government should be more open. We deserve a city government that does more than is required by state law. We deserve a city government that does what is right for the residents. This election is very important for Roosevelt. We want to take our city in a new direction with a diverse growth strategy that makes sense, with a strong small business community and an open and transparent government. Then we need some new faces in this table. My opponent and the city council, for the last 8 years, they had it their way. They had it the chance, and it's not working for the residents of Roosevelt. I hope that you will give me the chance to serve you and bring my resident perspective and my business perspective to the important decision this city council has to make in the next 4 years. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'd like to thank the Roosevelt Women's Club for organizing this forum. It takes a lot of work to put something like this on, and I really appreciate all the effort. And I appreciate each and every one of you for being here tonight. I'd also like to thank my lovely wife, Kelly, and my daughters, Caitlin and Kristen, whose love and support really make it possible for me to serve each and every one of you. I have a lot of conversations with Roosevelt residents. And one thing I consistently hear is that they love Roosevelt because it's such a great place to live. That's one of my first priorities, protecting and enhancing our quality of life. Through attractive neighborhoods, quality recreation, beautiful parks, creative arts and culture, and excellent schools. We also have a scenic river setting, historic charm, quality restaurants, and abundant festivals and events. All these go into making Roosevelt a unique, thriving community. We have a quality of life here in Roosevelt that is second to none. I'd put our quality of life up against any other city in this entire nation. That's why my family and I are glad to call Roosevelt home. That's why each of you are as well, I'm sure. That's also why I consider it a pleasure to serve our community. And while I will fight to protect our neighborhoods and enhance our quality of life, with a rebounding real estate market, we need to be especially vigilant in reviewing development proposals to protect against negative impacts for our existing neighborhoods, city services, and city infrastructure. Quality growth is essential. Roosevelt's fortunate to have over 900 acres of parkland and a number of streams and creeks all within its borders. These natural resources provide recreation and education opportunities, as well as hundreds of acres of undisturbed natural area for our city. Continued protection, maintenance, and investment in these natural assets contributes to our great quality of life. Just as integral to our Roosevelt community are schools, the arts, and an abundance of nonprofit organizations, all of which enrich our lives in very meaningful ways. Partnerships with these organizations enable each organization to expand its ability to serve Roosevelt and enhance our quality of life. Thank you so much for being here this evening. Your involvement in our community makes Roosevelt a better place.
Thank you. Mr. Palmero, your opening statement.
I also want to thank the Roosevelt Women's Club
Club for putting this together. I appreciate everybody that was able to come out tonight. We have a very important election in front of us, and I appreciate you being here to really make this very important decision on who you want to serve you. With that, I'm Mike Palermo, and I am here asking you to hire me to serve you on your certain city council. This is very important that I really want to work for you. And with that, I just want to know that I really see and I feel that I've talked to so many residents that also feel that just Roswell is such a great place to live. It has so many great things that it offers. It has strong, established neighborhoods, unique history, and really the best parks anywhere. And with that, my wife and I, we have a one-year-old, and God willing, our family will grow. And it is just so important that really for the sake of my family and the sake of your families, we need to make sure that Roswell continues to be the best area in all of Metro Atlanta. I am concerned with the direction that City Council has been bringing us. We've all seen this much higher density, really this much higher density development approaching our neighborhoods and our historic places. We need to protect what makes Roswell special. And on top of that, it is irresponsible to rezone when there's not the proper infrastructure in place to support this much higher density. And when I say infrastructure, I'm referring specifically to traffic, really the strain on our traffic, and the strain on our school systems. So although I really want to protect our neighborhoods and protect our history, I very much want to make sure to increase development where we need it. And what I mean by that is really the blighted areas. So think of with Highway 9 or Holcomb Bridge where we have vacant strip malls. These are the areas where I really want to focus our development instead of really approaching our neighborhoods. And with that, so I appreciate you taking the time to listen.
Thank you, Lynn.
Thank you, Mr. I appreciate it, and thank you, Women's Club, for putting this on for tonight. Since I was elected to the City Council 8 years ago, I have constantly reviewed my performance to make sure that I'm doing what I promised to preserve, protect, and enhance our quality of life. And since we've been approaching our November 3rd election, I will kind of share what we've been doing the last 8 years. And through the recession and recovery, I've concentrated on careful balancing budgets. And as a result, we have kept our services high, we've kept our military the same, and we've maintained our AAA priority. The city has developed tax incentives, formed an economic development organization, revised our codes, and created a downtown development authority, which is helping to rehabilitate those blighted, aging commercial centers that my opponent was talking about. Roswell's unique character is what brought my husband of 42 years of being here to Roswell, and this is where we want to stay and retire. While we're sometimes handcuffed by state law, last year we denied 40% of the rezoning applications because they were not appropriate for our city. And since the inception of the new codes, we're running closer to 50%. And of those that are approved, they are primarily conditioned based on neighborhood input. So yes, I am listening to the neighbors. I live here too, so quality of life is important to me. That's why we've added an adaptive sports field for our disabled citizens, have increased resources for beautifying our parks and our maintenance of our parks. And because you supported our recent bond referendum, we have now a therapeutic pool for our seniors and for our disability, our citizens with disabilities. Having been a neighborhood advocate for many years before taking office, I have been in your shoes many, many, many times, and understand that listening to you is critical. I humbly ask for your vote, and I would be honored to serve you for the next 4 years. Thank you so much.
Mr. Porter, your statement.
I just want to thank everybody for coming, and thank the Roswell Women's Club as well for putting this on. And I also want to apologize to everybody for being late. My flight was 2.5 hours delayed, otherwise I promise I would have been here on time. But just to introduce myself a little bit more, I'm a millennial. And a lot of times when I listen to these Roswell City Council meetings and when I listen to a lot of people talk, what I hear is how they talk about how they want to preserve Roswell for the future. They want to preserve Roswell for their kids and grandkids. I can be some of your guys' grandkids, just so you guys know. But they want to do it at the price of indebting their kids and grandkids. They want to take out bonds for senior pools, and they want to take out bonds for artificial turf. All those are things that people in my generation are going to have to pay for. Not necessarily the people that are voting for this stuff, not necessarily the people that live here now, but it's the future generations that are going to have to pay for it. And I'm not necessarily opposed to these, what I call vanity projects, these wants that we have in the city. What I prefer we do instead, though, is focus on our needs first. We need to put our wants aside, and we need to focus on needs. And the biggest need right now that we need to focus on is we need to focus on and deal with traffic. We have the Holcomb Bridge exit, which is abysmal. We need to deal with it. Obviously, the city, or not the city, the state foiled, so to speak, what we were trying to do. But that's not the only area that has problems. And I know a lot of times people are talking about how the issue is, well, it's not us driving on these roads. It's all these people that are coming through that are going to use us as cut-throughs and all those things. But I still drive on those roads, and regardless as to whether or not other people are going to use them, I still have to use them, and you still have to use them, and we all have to sit in that traffic. And that traffic wastes time, it wastes money, it's bad for the environment, it adds additional pollution, and that needs to be addressed first. We need to put these parks on hold. We have 900 acres, as was just pointed out. We don't need another 25 acres. What we need to do is we need to fix the roads, we need to address the transportation issues, and once we fix that, then we can start talking about some of these other things. But until that happens, we need to focus on our wants and not our needs and not our wants. Thank you.
Thank you, Spencer. Your statement.
Thank you. Many thanks to the Rossville Women's Club for their continued support to the Norfolk area. I read that you have contributed over $1.8 million in the past 18 years. That is truly amazing. And of course, thank you for the continued tradition to put on these public forums, which during election time, I truly appreciate it. Thank you, ladies. For the last 39 years, my life motto has been to serve and protect. I did that through a career as a firefighter. When I became the fire chief in Rossville in 2004, it was what a great milestone for me. I set that goal for myself in the late 20s and was so proud when I achieved it. I believe our lives boil down to the differences we make in the lives of others, which is what led me to run for city council post-retiring as fire chief. I want to continue to make a difference as a leader in the community. Being a resident of Rossville for 60 years, I've had a front row seat of watching it grow from a small town to one of the largest cities in the state. I take great pride in the city. I have given everything I have to this city and continue to serve as your council member to help steer us in the right direction as it grows is my number one priority. There is not one of my opponents who knows this city up close and personal like I do. I have qualifications that no other candidates close to Reed can compare. Setting and managing a $6 million budget for the fire department, 10 years as department head managing 140 employees, attending approximately 250 council meetings, collaborating with all city department heads for more than 10 years, vast knowledge of process and experience, knowing which ones work, and which ones need to be improved upon, and years of contributing to the community through service projects and mentoring. I'm the best candidate because I am for Rossville versus against Rossville and disheartened by current issues. I am here to listen to you. I'm here to act on your behalf. I'm here to serve you, and I'm here to protect you, and I'm here for you as I always have been. Thank you.
Thank you. Shane Gray, your statement.
Hey, everybody. I'm Shane Gray. I'm running for post three, and I'm going to be a little bit different than probably most everybody up here. You are not going to see me read. I was not read one time. I got a couple of notes on a scratch pad, but that's how I collect my thoughts. Everything you're going to hear from me is going to be 100% through the heart, not canned, not scripted, not polished, not mirrored. Looking 400 times in a mirror. I started my professional career at Pope Chevrolet in Roswell in 1996. I started selling cars. Don't hold that against me. I started selling cars and I moved up through the ranks. After 2 years, I was a very young 22-year-old and got promoted into management. I was the youngest sales manager at that time in the history of Chevrolet Southeast Region. that covers 11 states. I was the youngest. I've since moved within the exact same company, and it's changed hands to AutoNation, but I've moved up. I'm single-handedly responsible for the performance of 19 dealerships covering 2 states, 7 different cities, and at the end of this month, we will be adding in another 13 stores into my responsibility. The reason I bring that up is because I'm not the most well-known, even though my family goes back 8 generations. My grandmother was a Coleman. But I will say this, when you're looking at the future, I'm 39 years old. I was, by the way, told I should say that because I look much younger. So I wanted to give you, it's okay to vote for me. I'm not too young to hold the position. Because I will say this, my company, I'm directly responsible for $345 million in net sales every single year. I am uniquely qualified to handle the challenges that Roswell has to throw at me in the future. Thank you very much, and thank you, Roswell Women's Club.
How important your statement.
Thank you, Hatcher, and Roswell Women's Club for sponsoring this forum, and to everybody that's here that's wanting to hear about this important election. You know, Roswell's a great place to live, but some on our council are on the wrong track about the kind of city the people of Roswell want to live in. They changed their zoning rules, and in the process, they jeopardized the very things that give Roswell its appeal. If we don't do something about it now, it may be too late by the next election. We are already making profound changes. For example, in the historic district, instead of 35% lot coverage that was in the old zoning code, now it reads up to 70% lot coverage through the new UDC. That's double what it was. Density was removed from the code. So now we're going from 1 or 2 homes per acre to 5 or 6 homes per acre, and in some cases, 7 to 10 homes. And we're doing this next to established neighborhoods. And I have to ask why. Let me be clear. We need development, but our focus is wrong. We are neglecting blighted areas all over Roswell. And I say, let's redevelop. Today, 88% of the people who work in Roswell can't afford to live in Roswell. In fact, many of us have kids that can't afford to live here. But these new developments, they're all about $400,000 cottages, $600,000 townhouses, and instead we should be encouraging development that will create housing for the young professionals and young families that are the future of our city. But to do that, we need some new blood on City Council. You have a lot of choices for post 3, but I believe I'm the most qualified to deal with these issues. I have over 30 years' experience in business and a decade of service to my community. I've worked on the Roswell Initiative for Community Housing. I've helped neighborhoods and developers come together and create good projects that have the support of the people. I know and understand zoning and development from both the public and the private sector point of view, and I want to bring business experience, not just government experience, into our city operations. Most important, if you elect me, I will represent your interest on these issues and not march in step with the good old boys at City Hall. Thank you again, and I look forward to answering your questions.
Thank you.